set it right here and put the strainer right on top of it. And I can do it. And it won't work. You want the strainer like this. We'll figure it out. Ha. I have a purple, and the purple has the basic purple in it, basic acrylic. This is a teal, so I actually have some house paint that I had left over with some basic blue in it, so it turned into a teal. And then I have the basic yellow. And then I had, I think I threw it away, I had some old glitter glue that was left, so I'm going to see what happens with this. I do have some chunks in this that I'm probably going to work on and try to get rid of those before I put them through the strainer, because I don't think that's going to work real well. I've seen other people where they mix the colors together and then they put it in here. I'm going to just do one color at a time and see how that works. I did use this as to get my cells, so we'll see if we get some cells with using it. It is a hair product. It's called Color Preserve. So let's see how we're doing. I'm just seeing how the film looks. And we'll see how this works. I'm gonna put some purple in first. Strainer holes are really small in these strainers. I thought they would be a lot bigger when I looked at them online. So we'll see how this works. And I'm just going to go dark to light and just keep doing that and see if it works. It's either going to work or it's not. That's just the way it goes, right? Just experiment when you do it. Art. Ah! Or it falls over. Quite work the way I want it. Kind of pretty in the bottom cap there. I'll just flip that over. You might just do different spots. Yep, so much for the bottom cap. I'm gonna let that sit for a few seconds and see what happens. And I might just put it in a whole bunch of different spots. I'm just trying different things. The joy of art, right? I just need to be patient. But it is doing some interesting stuff. I kind of like it. Like I said, I just think I need to be patient. I think I'm just a little too impatient with my strainer. Let's see what happens. I can be a little more patient. And if this takes a really long time, I will just speed this up so that you guys don't have to sit here and watch the whole thing. But basically, you know, I'm just probably going to move this strainer around to different spots. Ooh, I kind of like that. It's kind of looking really good. So the strainers I got, I looked for them in different places. This one I got off of Amazon. There were 4 strainers for like $8. And I just thought I would try that and see what it looks like. actually really, really liking what's going on here, so we'll see if it keeps working. I really do like the colors. I watered the acrylic pour stuff down more than I normally do, so I was hoping that that would help it get through the strainer, and even that, it seems like it's taking time to get through the strainer. These get about the same size, and I'll move it again one more time. I think I might move it in a couple more corners and see what happens. Kind of fun, isn't it? Ooh, it's really, really pretty. I don't really see a whole lot of cells popping, but that just could be that they're just not going to do a lot of cells. It's really fun with these acrylic pours. I have fun when the stuff starts drying on my tools. It peels off really easy, so it's really kind of nice to know that. And even though I get messy and my stuff gets messy, I can still pour it off, and it still works really well. I think I'm going to put a little more purple on this one and see if I can get some more movement. Some more water. I do like it. It makes it flow a little nicer. So, we'll see if that works. But this is really pretty good. Yeah, I watered it down a lot. we'll see if I watered it down too much. Oh well. You know, live and learn. It's always fun to try. I'm impatient. Can you? I want them to move a little bit more, but they're still pretty. As I put it to the edge, it wants to move. Isn't that funny? Like, as I move it to the edge. Start tipping it and seeing if I can get it to get me some pretty designs. I actually kind of like that. It's really pretty. Hmm. Should I come over here and try one more? Put some blue. Yellow. I didn't think I was going to use all the paint for this, but I think I'm going to. I don't know. You think I should just tilt it? Let it go over the sides. I can see that this one's sides already tilting a little bit that way. Definitely gonna have to play with some of that. So I think we'll see what I can do there. I don't know. What do you think? I think I'm liking it. Let's see. Maybe tilt these on their side so I can get them to flow a little easier. Ooh. Get down more water. What do you think? What do you think? What do you think? What do you think? You think it's looking good? You think it's looking good? I don't want to water it down too much because I have seen that happen with my paints where when it flows off the side it just gets too much. But maybe just to move that on that edge there. See what happens. Ooh, it's flowing off the side there. That right there. It looks like it might have clogged it up a little bit. I'm not sure. But now I'm going to tip it a couple ways and see what it looks like. Well, I can really see that one with the water in it. It's really watery. So we'll try not to tip it too much that way. Tip it a little bit this way. Get some of that water to come off this way. Hoping that gold. So this is a 16 by 20. 16 by 20 canvas. And I'm going to put some of these on their sides so that I can get them. I'm going to pour some of the gold here. Just on the edge. I do see that I like this right here. Grab that and pour that right there. Help with some of that color there. That color. And I'll tip it some more and see what we can do here without making it blur too much. I don't want to blur all of these too much because I really like what's going on. A lot of water going on here. You can hear it dripping. Some fun stuff happening. Crazy stuff happening. Psychedelic. Really fun. So you can see all this paint here. Mm-hmm. I'll pour some of this here. Let's see if I can find some paint here. Here's some right here. I'll just kind of pull that off the sides. Pull these over. that's pretty. Actually, I kind of like what that does when it touches. Fun. All right, get this one. Pour some more yellow in there. Push the purple and yellow out. Some of that purple. Yep. Well, I probably gonna have to let the camera run a little longer because my hands are all peeing. See what's going on. Oh, like little flowers on the edges. Well, I think I just have to go around each of these sides now and check and make sure I have paint going everywhere. Wear socks when I do this because that just doesn't sounds counterintuitive, doesn't it? To wear socks when you paint them. I don't know why. It's just cold down here. Maybe that's why. And we'll see if I can get some cells to pop. I've got my gun, but I don't really see a whole lot going on cell-wise. But it does look really fun, doesn't it? So I'm pretty happy with it. Hands off, run the gun over it real quick, see if I can get any cells to pop. But other than that, I think I've got sparkles. There's tons of sparkles. I don't know if you can see the sparkles on my hands, but that glue really did get my sparkly. Ooh, your sign. Maybe some will pop out as it dries. I do notice that that happens sometimes as things dry. Ooh, there's some coming up right here. Oh, really pretty. I kind of like how the purple pops through with the cells. So I feel like I lost a lot of the gold. Oh, I can see some, like right here, just really small cells coming out. Oh, wow. I see a lot more as I'm doing this. So, I'm hoping as it dries, more cells will pop. And this will just look really more organic. But it does look really pretty. It's got a really interesting feel to it through the strainer. So, that is my pour through, my first pour through a strainer. I think I definitely am going to try a strainer with bigger holes. And that is a sink strainer. And I think I could have probably used a bigger strainer for this canvas. But it looks really pretty. Can't wait to see what it looks like when it's dry. I'll definitely put it out. See once it's dry, but I can see some of the sparkle golds coming through too, so I'm so happy I used that old gold. This is just a creme brulee little heater, so it works really well. I'm going to start playing with the resin, so I'm going to have to get a bigger torch for that, but oh wow, big cells coming in here. It's fun to see it dry as things change. Okay, well, I'm going to stop this and I will let you all see when it's dry. It usually takes my paintings 2 to 3 days to dry and a week before I varnish them. So I hope you like this and I hope you like the way it looks. Thank you very much. Take this a little closer so you guys can see some of those cells. As you can tell, can you see those? Really pretty cells coming out. So we'll see what it looks like when I'm done. Now, like I said, that cell really pops really big. Pull back a little bit so you can see the whole thing. And then I'll stop it.